literally has already blocked me. It's Rosalind Talusan. I don't know who this is. Not me having to defend a celebrity white woman on 420. It's important to consider the context under which Heard hit Depp. Reactive violence is situational, occurring when a victim uses violence to respond to abuse. Tasia Van Rie says, Heard was wrongfully accused of domestic violence. I recount hints of homophobia when they found out we were domestic partners and not just friends. Charges were quickly dropped and she was released moments later. Oh, that's really interesting. Okay, well, this person either is completely oblivious to additional facts of the case or is being disingenuous, but the cop that fucking arrested them was literally a lesbian. Just saying. So, you know, that's cool. This is the prior incident Amber Heard had when Amber Heard attacked her ex-girlfriend at Seattle Tacoma Airport. And then they literally were like, oh, they just did this because they're homophobic or they're lesbophobic. And that's why they said it was domestic abuse. It was blown out of proportion. Rosalind is a well-known media lib who honestly has sided with some shady industry people. Yeah. Depp's own daughter saw how Heard had a positive impact on him, which he, according to live tweets from today's proceedings, resented. Johnny Depp's own daughter wrote text on how he wasn't really a good father, pleading him to not break with Amber, but thanks for opening that so Amber's team can bring the text now. Hashtag stand with Amber. Depp has accused Heard of throwing a bottle at him, severing the top of his middle finger. Her attorneys have pointed to text messages in which Depp admitted to cutting the finger himself. That is an insane defense. That is literally, like, this is irrelevant, okay? A third party from afar and their analysis on the situation can vary depending on, like, individual acts of abuse that they cannot have seen. Something that I always say when I talk about, even when cops and other people approach Amber Heard throughout the relationship, where I've always said, look, like, you know, abuse can be very hidden. Domestic violence can be hidden. So that's silly to use that. But this is the silliest fucking response, that Johnny Depp cut his own finger off because he said, I cut my finger. Or the other text message where he basically said, he joked about, you know, I'm going to chop my finger off again like I chopped my finger. That's ridiculous. During their marriage, Depp beat, then raped her with an object. He's 20 years older than her, a rich white male actor in Hollywood who pursued her. Power differentials like this in intimate relations are ripe for abuse. That is fucking psychotic. Amber Heard was 27 years old. 27 years old. I'm sorry. I will not stand for this. I do not give a fuck. Okay? Power dynamics between a 27-year-old grown-ass woman and a fucking 50-year-old guy. Oh my God. At what age can a woman not be infantilized? Is that a... What is the power dynamic? A grown-ass lady? Damn, dude. Look at the power dynamic. If anything, the power dynamic sways in her fucking favor. Okay? In that situation, because she's like at her peak, at her prime, mentally. Whereas this fucking addict is literally severely brain broken at the age of fucking 50. Get the fuck out of here, dude. 27 year young. At this point, she's 36, man. What the fuck? Nice save, Lamau. Hassan MRA arc, lol, JK. No, it just, like, really frustrates me that, like, liberals play fast and loose with these, like, insane concepts that are so damaging and so real, like grooming and predatory behavior. Oh, man, the fucking power dynamic between a 50-year-old and a 27-year-old? What the fuck are we talking about, dude? What fucking power dynamic? Unless Johnny Depp is, like, her boss or some shit, what power dynamic are we fucking talking about? Like, I hate this. I hate that, like, MRAs can use this as a fucking argument to belittle and make people look ridiculous. Don't fucking concede to that position. Don't let, like, psychotic incel shitheads come across like they're fucking right to the average human being and with a fucking brain cell by consistently infantilizing women in these sorts of arguments. Like, 27, dude. Iconic problematic age gap, yeah. I mean, it wasn't like she was Julia Roberts or Kim Kardashian. I mean, dude, it's like, what is there to happen in that situation? If you're just like, if you're someone who's famous, okay, I guess you just can't like ever fucking date someone. You have to go and like find someone who is, and this means like you need to do quantitative and qualitative analysis to see like how much clout your fucking partner has. Like, that's so stupid. They met on the fucking set, dude. She's 27 years old. I'm sorry. I will not stand for that, okay? And she's famous herself. You know what I mean? Motherfuckers literally look at, like, a 23-year age gap and not realize that the potential victim in the situation is a whole-ass, grown-ass woman, bro. God damn, dude. Anyway, Judge Mr. Nicole found 12 of the 14 alleged instances of domestic violence that occurred in plain terms a matter of fact that Johnny Depp did perpetrate domestic violence against Heard, and that he is a wife beater. Again, the fucking the 12 out of the 14 alleged incidents do not fucking favor Amber Heard at all when you look at the actual details of said incidents. There are some where Johnny Depp, in my opinion, I think two specific ones where there are additional victims as well, there are some where Johnny Depp is engaging in acts of violence against Amber Heard, okay? There are two. But in that fucking court case, out of the 14, even in instances where Amber Heard openly admits that she's fucking beating Johnny Depp's ass, the judge was like, well, you know, you did that to defend yourself, milady. Like, that's crazy. That's fucking nuts, dude. How are you going to look at that and go, yeah, this is actually a pretty good court case. Like, this outcome was, like, totally fucking reasonable and valid. I knew him to be soft and gentle with a temper and a dark side, but a golden heart. I didn't want to believe it either until I saw the wreckage. When you call someone your brother, you also commit to call them out when they're wrong. Why I called 911? E.O. Tillett Wright explains in his own words. Today, Depp repeatedly misgendering Wright during his testimony. Wait, what? What? What the oh God, I just got liberals, man. Liberals. Insisting that a man who has been both transphobic and homophobic cannot possibly have abused his bi wife is certainly something. Yo. Fuck me. Just, I can't do this. We look like fucking psychos, man. We look like psychopaths. Like, progressive, liberal people, they just, like, they look like psychopaths when they do this. Like, an instance where, like, you can admit that it's a morally gray area, and there are certainly, like, instances where Johnny Depp has been abusive, which I agree to, and that's, like, true, but it's obvious that the prior understanding of the case and the prior understanding of domestic abuse in the situation completely favored Amber Heard, who controlled the narrative and utilized Johnny Depp's addiction issues to make him out to be even more of a fucking villain and not also someone who was being victimized by domestic violence, openly admitted to by Amber Heard herself. How the fuck can you turn around and be like, well, actually, he was being transphobic? Okay, fucking kill him then, dude. I mean, holy fuck. Misgendered what? Like a non-binary person? I don't know who this is. Johnny Depp's doing? Misgendered who? Who did this 60-year-old man misgender? Please, I don't know. During a night of drinking and drugs, John Depp allegedly becomes enraged with a female friend who heard his flirts with her. He threatens to break the woman's wrist and then damages the trailer they were staying in and refers to her as a lesbian camp counselor. Oh, the lesbian camp counselor thing. Okay, kill him. He said Amber Heard was a lesbian camp counselor. Fucking kill him then, I guess, I think, right? That's how you're supposed to do it. Was he, I mean, you know, holy shit, dude. Oh, God. It's just like, it's crazy. Hannah is right. From the article above, domestic abuse occurs in the power imbalance within a relationship. For example, the one between a beloved 52-year-old cishet male actor and his 29-year-old bisexual wife. Dude, I'm about to say some shit that is going to, never mind. Look, I love my bi chatters. I'm not going to say some shit right now out of anger, okay? Buy visibility always. All right. I'm with you. I stay with you. Holy fuck, dude. But they're, oh my God. Oh my fucking God, dude. Oh my God. I'm bi. Please don't believe. No, I'm not going to. Obviously not. Amber Heard's bisexuality has nothing to do with their relationship. What the fuck? I mean, Johnny Depp dating an up-and-coming actress, there's obviously a power difference. Dude, shut the fuck up. This person is literally trying so desperately to fucking make Amber Heard out to be like a bigger victim in the situation where she herself has perpetrated acts of violence against Johnny Depp and admits that she has done so and has belittled him and has gaslit him and has personally fucking said that no one will believe you if you do end up coming out. Like, personally, there are multiple parties involved in this relationship over the course of many years that have said that they had not seen instances of domestic violence. Obviously, that doesn't mean that domestic violence had not happened. This is something that I personally admit and recognize clearly, okay? But Amber Heard's bisexuality in this relationship does not give her fucking carte blanche to, you know, beat the shit out of Johnny Depp or try to actively maintain a very toxic and mutually abusive relationship by constantly fucking starting trouble and even going so far as to hit him so that he does not leave. And this is not my analysis. This is the analysis of the marriage counselor that said exactly these fucking words, okay? That Amber Heard routinely would cause problems in the relationship, specifically so that they would argue, because arguments meant that the relationship would continue and extend more instead of allowing Johnny Depp to walk away. We know this also because it corresponds to the audio that we have listened to from said relationship in which Johnny Depp is trying to walk away. And Amber Heard keeps saying, you can't walk away. And has even hit Johnny Depp in situations where he has tried to walk away. It is so fucking psychotic to be like, well, Amber Heard is just a small bean. She's just a tiny little bisexual woman. Oh, she's just a small bean. Like, shut the fuck up, dude. Shut the fuck up. What is this psychopathic infantilization of like a 29-year-old woman who was being fucking abusive in the relationship? What the fuck is wrong with you? Oh my God. Jesus Christ, dude.
Drove the SUV provided by Johnny, put the animals and all the luggage in and headed out to the
bin. Oh, is this when they smuggled the animals
in? The morning of April 22nd, did you see any injuries on Miss Heard?
No marks. No injuries.
And so, driving out to Coachella, did anyone drive with you?
Oh, no, this is not the illegal.
I was in the car alone except for the animals.
And how did Miss Heard get to Coachella?